Hello, class. This is Professor Poepping. So last time, we saw this list of kinematic equations that are applicable for problems with a constant acceleration. Now let's solve some problems using these equations. Here's a simple example involving 1D motion, where we've got unknown time parameters. A rocket is launched vertically from rest, as shown in the figure, and when it reaches an altitude of 4.7 kilometers above the launch pad, its speed is 630 meters per second. What is the magnitude of the rocket's acceleration? Where it tells us, we can assume that it's constant. Okay, first let's sketch it out. Here we've got the rocket launching from a position here that we're going to call x naught equal to zero. So at time t naught equal to zero, we've got an x naught equal to zero, and we've got a v naught equal to zero, because it starts from rest. We're going to define this as the positive direction upward, and we can see that at some time t later, undefined time, we have a position that is 4.7 kilometers, and we've got a V that is 630 meters per second. So we've got the rocket moving upwards with a velocity V. It's going to be a positive velocity. And we've got an acceleration that is upwards. And it's a positive acceleration, and it's equal to a constant. If we look at that on the time plots, what's it going to look like? Well, it's already told us that it's a constant acceleration problem. And if it's a constant acceleration problem, that means that we're going to have a straight line on the velocity versus time plot. So it's starting at a velocity v equal to zero and extending up to some velocity where we know that at a given time here, that's the time that we know when the height is going to be equal to, or sorry, the velocity is going to be equal to 630 meters per second. So you'll notice it's a straight line because it's a constant acceleration, and the acceleration is the slope of the velocity time, right? So we have here a positive constant slope. Okay, and that is our acceleration. What does the corresponding position versus time plot look like? If it's a constant acceleration, it means we have a linear velocity, and it means we have a quadratic position. Where are we starting with the position? We're starting with an x naught equal to zero at t naught. We're going to start out with a low velocity or a low slope, and then we're going to increase in slope value because the velocity is increasing. And so as we go, it gets progressively steeper and steeper. In other words, a quadratic. And we also know that our position after some time t is 4.7 kilometers. Okay. Let's work with that now. First, we're going to identify the known and unknown quantities. We've done that partly on the figure already, but let's take inventory on the next page. We already said that at t naught equal to zero, we saw that we had an initial position of zero, an initial velocity of zero, and we had an acceleration that was given to be positive but unknown. Sometime later at T, which is still an undefined time, we have a position that is 4.7 kilometers. And I'm going to convert that, in fact, right now, where I know that there's 10 to the 3 meters per 1 kilometer. So when I add my conversion factor, those kilometers get canceled out, and I'm going to have 4.7 times 10 to the 3 meters. And I also have a velocity, a known velocity at that time, which is a positive 630 meters per second. Okay, I'm gonna just for emphasis show that these are all positive quantities here. Okay. Next, I want to determine which equations are needed. Okay. Right now, you'll notice that my times are unknown, but I know my positions, both dispositions, and therefore I know my displacement, and I know both velocities. So that should tell me that one of the equations that might be useful is one that avoids the use of time. In other words, this equation that deals with velocity and displacement alone. What else do I know now? I know that V naught is zero. I know that X naught is zero. I don't know my acceleration, but I do know my final velocity. And it's the acceleration that I'm trying to solve for. And so I just need to rearrange that equation in order to isolate for the value that I want to solve for. In other words, I now have acceleration is equal to V squared divided by 2x. And make sure I plug in the correct values, 630 meters per second. That all gets squared. And on the bottom, I've got 2 times my position, which I saw was 4.7 times 10 to the 3 meters. And that ends up being 42. And what are my units? Off to the side, I'm just going to check that I've got a meters per second that gets squared, and I'm dividing by meters. So I should end up with meters per second squared, as expected for acceleration. So the acceleration is a positive 42 meters per second squared.